Hi and welcome. In this video, I will discuss five technologies which are used to provide AAA services to ensure the centralized security of network resources once these resources are being accessed remotely by a user. Now, AAA services stands for authentication, authorization, and accounting. And a network resource can be a switch or it can be a server. Now these five technologies are TACX, which stands for Terminal Access Controller, Access Control System, and then is the X-TACX, which is Extended TACX. Next one is the TACX Plus, and next one is RADIUS, which stands for Remote Authentication Dial-in User Service, and next one is the Diameter. Now I have prepared this video out of these four books and also the material available on Wikipedia, and I will put the links in the description below. I have prepared two slides, and in the first slide I will discuss the general architecture of these AAA services provided by these five technologies, and in second slide I have conducted a comparison of these five technologies. Please join my channel for encouragement if you like this video. Now the purpose of these five technologies is to provide centralized and scalable AAA services to ensure the security of remote network access. Now, authentication means that the credentials of a user are being checked to either allow him or deny his access to a network resource. And then in authorization, we check whether the user is allowed certain kind of actions or not. So this authentication is one or zero. It means that either the user is allowed access to a resource or it is denied. Whereas in authorization, the numbers of action may vary depending upon the privileges associated with different users. And third A is the auditing, also known as accounting, in which we basically records all the activities of the users and all its action on the system. So the purpose of these AAA services is to provide accountability for the user so that he may be held liable for any negative actions or activities he conducts on the system or on the network. Now I will explain the general architecture of these AAA services. So these are numbers of remote users who wants to access the network devices or network resources. So these network resources can be a VPN server or dial-in server, or it can be a wireless access point. Now this is the AAA server, which can be a RADIUS server or TACX or Diameter. Now first of all, the client or the user sends their credentials and their request to access a particular network device. Now previously, each network device maintained its local database of the users, but it was not scalable due to the expansion of networks and the users, because then on each network device we had to maintain the local database of hundreds of users. So it was not manageable. Therefore, this responsibility was transferred to the AAA server, where instead of checking or maintaining its local database, device sends request of the client to the AAA server, where our local our centralized database of users' credentials is maintained. So this AAA server then checks the credentials of remote users at a single location or at a single server. And if these credentials are checked out and verified, then these remote users or the client to the network resources or devices are allowed access to these devices. So the remote user is the client to the network devices or network resources, where the network devices are client to the AAA server. Now there can be multiple technologies or AAA servers deployed in the same network. For example, we may use the TechX Plus server for the remote login, because TechX Plus is more granular and it records and it actually authorizes each separate command of admin. So it is more granular. Whereas we may use Radius for other normal VPN users, because there are less overheads with the Radius. Now in this slide, I have carried out a comparison of these five AAA technologies. And here you can see that the TechX series are connected with each other, and Radius and Diameter are linked and related to each other. So the TechX or Terminal Access Controller, Access Control System, this protocol was introduced in 1984 for the authentication of Unix networks. So it was used in the MILNET, which was a part of ARPANET for the Department of Defense Unclassified Networks. Then around 1990s, the Cisco adopted this TechX, and they introduced their own implementation with the name of Extended TechX. Then in 1991, this Radius was introduced, and in 1993, this TechX Plus was again used by Cisco. Then in around 1980, this Diameter was introduced, and as per the journal definition of Diameter, it is twice as the Radius. Therefore, in this context of this AAA services, the Diameter is considered twice as good as the Radius. Now this TechX Plus, TechX was introduced by BBN Technologies, and it was a proprietary protocol, but RFC is also published. And this TechX and the TechX Plus was formulated by the Cisco, and it is a proprietary, both are the proprietary protocol, but the RFC is also published by one of the employee in 1993. Then this Radius is open Internet Engineering Task Force standard, and it was formulated by Livingston, and Diameter is also open. So the TechX series is proprietary protocols, whereas the Radius and Diameter are open protocol. Now TechX is not backward compatible with the TechX, and Radius is however compatible with DSL, ISDN and T1. Now this TechX Plus is a totally different protocol than its predecessors, that is TACX and XTACX. So it is also not backward compatible. And diameter is also not backward compatible with the radius. Now this radius has a vulnerability that it's only the passwords are encrypted, not the username and other authentication data. Moreover, the passwords are static. The TACX Plus encrypts all the authentication information, including the passwords and the usernames. And it also uses one-time passwords instead of using the static passwords, which is the case with the radius. Now, this diameter does not use any encryption, and it depends upon TLS and IPsec for encryption. Now this TACX combines the authentication and authorization information in the same session, whereas in XTACX and the TACX Plus there is separate authentication and authorization. For example, each command of a admin while he is using the secure shell or SSH, so each SSH command is authorized individually. So Radius also combines this triple A services. Therefore, it is used for VPN user instead of using for admin logins or recording admin authenticating or authorizing admin commands. So there is an attribute value pair value which actually dictates the numbers of services supported by the radius, and this value is of 1 byte. So the values are around 256, that is 2^8. So TACX Plus not only separates the triple A services, that the authentication and authorization, in different sessions, and it also introduced two-factor authentication, and it also uses a greater range of attribute value pairs than radius. Now this diameter uses 32-bit attribute value pairs, so the numbers of services and functionality it supports are greater, or a lot greater than the radius. Moreover, the diameter uses peer-to-peer architecture, whereas all other four technologies uses client-server architecture, where only the client can initiate the request or connection to the server. But in diameter, the diameter server can also request authentication from the user. Now this TACX uses port 49, TCP and UDP both. And this XTACX also uses same ports. And this radius earlier used port 1645 for authentication and 1646 for authorization, and these were non-official ports, but now it uses 1812 for authentication and 1812 for authorization. But one of the drawback is that radius only uses UDP, it does not use TCP, so there is not much reliability as compared to the TACX or diameter. So TACX uses port 49 TCP, so it is more reliable than radius. And diameter also uses the TCP and stream control transmission protocol, which is and both are more secure than UDP or reliable than UDP. So this TCP actually processes data in bytes, whereas this SCTP processes data in messages. So this is the difference between TCP and SCTP. Now this RADIUS is a lightweight protocol since it uses UDP, and there are less overheads with the RADIUS as compared to the TACX plus and other diameter. Now ISP uses this RADIUS, and there is a mechanism they known as callback, where ISPs terminate connections of our connecting client, and then they reconnect to that client IP as a protection layer. So this RADIUS supports password authentication protocol, challenge handshake authentication protocol, and extensible authentication protocol. Moreover, it also supports location-based services based on the IP of that user. And it is said that the accountability or accounting or recording of the user's actions are more in RADIUS than in TACX Plus. But RADIUS is not as granular as TACX Plus because it does not authorize each single command of an admin, which is the case with the TACX Plus. So moreover, it is not as flexible as the TACX Plus or diameter, because attribute value pairs are less than the TACX Plus or the diameter, and it is not as scalable as other two technologies. So TACX Plus is more granular than RADIUS because it authorizes each single command of an admin or of a user. And TACX Plus supports AppleTalk, NetBIOS, and IPX. Now diameter has single policy server, whereas in RADIUS there are multiple policy servers. So diameter is easy to manage with regards to the network policies. Moreover, diameter supports IP mobility, where the user can roam around and he can still use his home IP. So there is a care of IP. So all the traffic first forwarded to this home IP and then to this care of IP while this user is roaming around. So the diameter supports voice over IP, fax over IP, and proxy services. Moreover, it uses the application layer acknowledgement and also the failover functionalities. So overall, the TACX, X-TACX, and RADIUS are less efficient and less secure than the TACX Plus and diameter. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel and join my channel and like this video for encouragement. Thank you.